they too purify their hearts and minds in order to let go of all self-concern, ideas of rank, etc. So they enter the tea room just being very present in the moment with each other. Tea is a way to offer peace, and we create harmony. We have respect, which is paramount. Purification, or say, one of the principles of tea is purity. And then, of course, if all three are present, harmony, respect, and purity, tranquility, the last of the principle, naturally arises. It's about the whole process of offering tea in this way is to create peace for each other and to connect with each other in a very genuine way. And not just with each other, but with nature itself. The way of tea is in tandem with nature always. It's seasonal according to the time of year, the season that we're in. So whatever we bring into a tea gathering, we also bring in nature and the season. Before making tea, we always warm the tea bowl, and during the summer months, use different shaped tea bowls. They're mostly shallow because it gives a feeling of coolness when the tea is being made for the guests to receive and enjoy. In winter, we have more deep tea bowls. This particular bowl is from Japan. It has a summer design on it. Porcelain with this beautiful design on summer flowers. So everything that we use in a tea gathering, the tea water container jar that the lid was just open for, to add cold water into the kettle if the water is too hot. Make tea with just two scoops, bevel scoops of tea, and use about half of the ladle, of water ladle that is according to the tea bowl. And of course you blend it with a fine bamboo tea whisk. The shape of the tea whisk, the design of it, really began in China back in the Song Dynasty. So the design is still absolutely the same. And generations of what we call tea whisk makers, chasen makers, are represented in Japan. And they come from Japan. All the tea whisks are made in Japan. It's hard to whisk tea without the bamboo tea whisk. Some people have tried it in various ways, including an electric mixer, and I say no, please don't. To really enjoy a proper bowl of tea, you do need this. So when the tea is made, the guest moves forward to receive the tea. And you'll notice that there are various ways that we do this. The front of every utensil faces either the host or the guest, and the tea bowl has a front that the host has picked and offered to the guest. And we do a lot of bowing in the tea, part of the symbol of respect, because gratitude naturally arises when respect is present. respect and gratitude sort of go hand in hand. So before we drink the tea, we always raise the bowl. And this is actually to say thank you to the universe and everything that made this tea happen. And if you think about it, there is nothing that's missing in that tea bowl. So we are actually, when we drink that bowl of tea, we're drinking the entire universe as well. All that made it possible. Principles of harmony, harmonizing with the season, etc. Respect for each other and everything. Purity in the cleanliness of everything around you, including what's most important, your heart and mind. And of course, tranquility arises when all of these principles are present. And the reason we try and enter the tea room with a cleansed heart and mind is only so that we can be present with each other in a moment without the mind being hindered by many thoughts of self-concern. Are the sounds or the natural sounds in the tea room, the sound of the bubbling of the kettle, the steam rising from the kettle, is reminiscent of the wind in the pines, and the sound of the wind in the pines, the sound of the water being poured into a tea bowl. So we are, when we are this present with the mind unhindered, we can appreciate every moment that it brings us, every experience of the moment. Each procedure is exact in economy of movements. There's a seamless interaction between host and guest. They say that the role of the host is that of the guest. The role of the guest is that of the host. And each form a unity that sort of intensifies each action as it arises. They're not separate, but one. It's we need a host as a guest, a host needs a guest to enjoy the tea that they made. The study of tea, of course, takes time, but we love it because it so improves our lives. The discipline, awareness and concentration brings peace to our lives, to our hearts and mind. And we can share this peace with what's so wonderful with each other. There's a grace in the movements, there's an art in the presentation, in the utilization of all the various utensils, the ceramics that we use in tea.